Lengempela ke umlalelo mohle siyahamba isikhathi sami sithi mizuzu imashumi amabili nesithupha ngaphambi kokuthi kubumbane ihora ele shumi nambili kwiSoshanguve Community Radio. Sibonge inkulumo evela kuyena ke uMEC wezezimali khona ngapha ke esifundazweni saseGauteng lapho khona ke ubebhekelele udaba okukuthi umlalelo mohle ke bekanika mhlambe kathi ke ingxenye yezezimali ukuthi ke ingabe ke imali ingasetshenziswa wage ngaluphi ke uhlobo ikakhulukazi babhekelele ekutheni kungongwa imali futhi ke kubhekeleleke izinto ukuthi mhlambe they should be a priority ekutheni ke zibhekelelwe kuyisabelo zimali nokuthi ke imali ingasetshenziswa kanjani ikakhulukazi uma ziza ke ngasemnyangweni wezempilo ezemfundo infrastructure ekubhekeleleni ekhupuleni ke umnotho wangakuthina nasekutheni ke kwakhiwe ke amathuba omsebenzi sisakhuluma ke ngamathuba omsebenzi namhlanje ke sinenhlanhla we are we have one of our visitors ukuthi ke uzosinika an opportunity ikakhulukazi uma usekhaya kunabantu ukuthi ke basenga uma business ukuthi bayafufusa basemalokishini they can't get usizo they can't get a business because of abantu ukuthi abazeki even us as a community we tend to take advantage of them ukuthi uma umuntu ekhona engiyenzele okuthize just because umuntu wasekhoneni umuntu waselokishini we feel like they don't deserve to be paid enough money we feel like we can use them as we please sometimes we take our fridges kubona basilungisele and then when we have to pay it becomes a problem manje ke let me take this time and opportunity to welcome our guest we have Ryan Haynes today. He's an HR manager from the Frigoglass. Yeah, am I right? Yes, Frigoglass. Mr. Ryan Haynes, can you kindly greet our listeners at home?
Hi, family. Hi, all the listeners.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us more about Frigoglass?
Okay, no problem. Frigoglass. So what we do in essence is we manufacture coolers in South Africa. So if you go to, say, for example, a shopping facility, shopping market, and you go buy a 2-liter cool drink, those big red coolers or fridges, as we locally call them, that is what we manufacture down here in South Africa. We are also represented across the globe, so it's a global company. We have a couple of bottling plants up in Nigeria, so yes, fairly well-stabled company looking to partner with local businesses and looking for business opportunities so that we can facilitate future growth prospects for the local teams.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us more about the program itself? Because I believe that you have partnered with the DTI, and just tell us the motive behind why have you decided to come up with such a program?
Okay, this is a fantastic opportunity. So it's called the EEIP, stands for Equity Equivalent Investment Program.
Mm-hmm.
We all know that down here in South Africa, especially locally, we are experiencing unemployment, for example.
Yes.
We're experiencing businesses that's closing, for example. And this program looks to partner with you so that we can create a sustainable future for you as an individual if you have a company in the service industry, or we'll talk about it a little bit later.
Okay.
With regards to our localization prospects and the logistics program that we're about to embark on.
Mm-hmm. As we are talking about the program itself, our listeners at home, they might be asking, what are the skills that you are looking for in the businesses that you are going to work with?
Oh, okay. So if you are out there and you have a, say for example, let me touch on the streams.
Yes.
So we have three streams that we have identified internally. One is called localization program, where we're looking to localize what we import as components for the coolers. I'm going to call them fridges so that it's easier to reference. Okay. So localizing, we import some of our components that we build the coolers or the fridges with.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, logistics. We obviously need spares to be picked up.
Yes.
We need the fridges to be delivered wherever they need to go. That's the localized, that's the logistics program side of things. And then one big, massive opportunity is something called the repairs and maintenance of the fridges program.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what we are wanting people to take advantage of.
Okay.
So to answer your question, if we have people out there that have worked in the service industry, for example, of the fridges, repairs and maintenance.
Yes.
This is the opportunity that you need to grab. We will be looking to partner with you, create infrastructure, share our technical knowledge and expertise with you,
mm-hmm.
Train where we can,
okay.
Develop the business, hold the hand of that entrepreneur, for example, and then also look at where, after we do a nice gap analysis on the business itself or the individual to see how best we can suit the company,
mm-hmm.
Look at possible investments where we see opportunities to do so.
Mm-hmm. What I like about this program, it's that sometimes, you know, we have people who are not qualified to do certain jobs,
mm-hmm.
but they are excelling in what they are doing. So now what I love about this program is that you have training parts whereby if one doesn't have maybe a qualification, for an example,
yes.
then you are able to take them through a process of training which will enable them to do the job accordingly.
Correct.
Which is a good thing.
Yes,
and
yes.
Now can you just take us through the process itself? How does one apply the contract and everything? Just take us through the process.
Okay. Very simple. We made it easy for everyone. We've launched about, say, a week or 2 weeks back on Facebook.
Okay.
So if you have to search for FGSA,
mm-hmm.
that stands for Frigoglass SA.
Okay.
Space EEIP. That's the name of the program. So I repeat, FGSA, mm-hmm. space EEIP.
Okay.
On Facebook or on LinkedIn, you will get to see all our information over there. Exciting news over there. So that has a link where you click on. It will take you through to a landing page. On the landing page, it will explain to you more about the three opportunities or streams which I mentioned, the localization, mm-hmm. repairs and maintenance, and or logistics. Once you click on that, it will take you through to the application phase or stage or page, if you'd like to call it that, and you upload all the information on there. Simple. The closing date, however, you have to know is the 13th of December, because we're looking to roll this process out in January. The vetting process will kick in January,
mm-hmm.
so that we can then do the gap analysis on the selected companies or individuals.
Mm-hmm.
So, simple. Go okay. to Facebook, go to LinkedIn. Our videos are there. It's also on YouTube. If you search, you'll find us.
Okay. So, let us talk about the contracted companies.
Mm-hmm.
Do they only receive a contract, or do you plan on including other business support?
If you can be more specific, what business support?
Okay, let's talk about there's a company
yes.
that has been contracted.
Mm-hmm.
So do you also give them an opportunity? Do you give them another contract?
Okay, so what it is, first of all, it's a three-year program.
Okay.
So we want to partner with say, let's call the guy Tabu.
Okay.
We want to partner with Tabu. We want to make sure that Tabu's business is going to be successful,
mm-hmm.
sustainable. We want him to be able to employ staff going forward,
mm-hmm.
okay, with the growth opportunities.
Yes.
In that 3-year period, we will support where we can invest, train, develop, and give him the support.
Okay. Can I get
yes?
clarity? If, let's say, I get a contract from you guys.
Okay.
So it's going to be a 3-year contract.
Okay, yes.
Am I right?
Yes, yes.
So you are going to take me through the 3 years. It mm-hmm. means throughout the business, you are going to monitor.
Correct.
Oh, okay.
Correct.
Okay.
Look, it's we don't want the business to be independent on Frigoglass alone. That is why we want to lift the guy's hand or the lady's hand. So that they can expand their business. That is what we are all about. Not being solely dependent on Frigoglass.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So now let's talk about your services, because each and every time when you get someone who's saying to you, I want to hold your hand.
Yes.
I want to assist you in your business. And as a person, then I become skeptical to say, you know, this guy, as soon as I flourish or my business flourish, he's going to rob me. It's going to be a problem. They're going to take the half of my money. Some of them, they might take everything, or they might take my business, because, yes, you know, we have this mentality. We've been robbed. I mean, we have a lot of corruption. Then the moment you say you're going to get somebody who's going to help you in your business, then you are starting to think that, oh my God, I'm going to lose my business. I'm going to, you know.
So, I understand.
Tell us more about your services. Do I have to pay anything in the contract? What is in the contract? Because now the mistake that we make as people, we tend to sign contracts.
Correct.
Without understanding what is in the contract.
Okay. So one thing that we need to understand is, first of all, it's for free.
Okay.
There's no clauses or small terms and conditions that we're going to take shares, or it's for free. It's your business, and we want to partner to make a success of your business. That's all. What governs us is that we obviously, with partnering with the DTI,
okay,
facilitates the whole process as well. So we report on a monthly basis to the DTI, and the success ratio that we want to portray back to them is what makes this program key. So, to reflect on what your question was, you know, the fear of losing and being, how can I say, robbed. It's not the case at all. Not the case at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So now, coming back to Soshanguve, somebody might ask themselves, why have you chosen a Soshanguve community, and what are you hoping to achieve at the end of the day?
Okay. Nationally, first of all, globally, our footprint is there. Nationally, if you go into your local supermarket, 9 out of 10, guaranteed you will see that there's a cooler in that supermarket with Frigoglass's little name tag at the bottom, right-hand side. It's part of our community. It's where we live. It's where we grew up with or in.
Mm-hmm.
So some of our staff are from the area, and we are looking to expand with new opportunities in the current area, so that we can uplift, support, grow. It's all about that. We understand that Shosanguve, being an outlying skirts of, for example, Pretoria.
Yes.
Job scarcity is it's here.
This
is an opportunity where we can support those guys or ladies, so that they can create, you know, a sustainable future for not only them, who is the business owner, but also to employ from the local community. So it's all about partnership, and that's what we're about.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And the other question would be, We understand that whenever you are working, for an example, if I get hired in a certain company, they will tell me that, okay, we are going to give you a contract, and your contract will be, for an example, it's a 12-month contract.
Mm-hmm.
And then in that contract, I'll be advised that every month you will get a certain amount in a month. Then I have an idea that, okay, if then I sign this contract, then I know that in 12 months to come, each and every month, maybe I'll be getting something like 3.5. Maybe, do you have a guaranteed level of income for the companies that you sign up with?
That's a very important question. So part of the vetting process, vetting means that when we say we call Tabu in.
Yes.
And we invite him to do a presentation to the committee.
Mm-hmm.
We will take him through, for example, if he's in the Shosanguve area, we can, share the data of breakdowns of the technical support need in the area with him. We've got the stats.
Okay.
So he will already have an understanding of what is the projection going forward.
Mm-hmm.
Built on the stats that we have collected over the years. You understand? So that is open cards that we will play with the individuals,
okay,
with the businesses, so that they can also have a foresight on business opportunities. Yeah.
But is it always accurate? Because now you do your research.
Yes.
And then when it comes to implementation, is it always accurate?
Must be.
It must be.
Because we are reporting with compliance data.
Mm-hmm.
Through to our partner.
Okay. Okay, before we can wrap up, can you kindly expand on the future direction of the program before we can wrap up our conversation?
So I think what makes it a great opportunity is, yes, we are based in Johannesburg, but this opportunity, this venture, is a rollout program that's not only confined to Johannesburg.
Okay.
We're national. You understand?
Yes.
So where we can, we have a stepping process, which first year we'll concentrate on local. Second year we will expand further, and then the final year will be a rollout throughout South Africa, which is national. So if you are out there and you're hungry and thirsty for business opportunity, and you open for, you know, another company, a global company with high standards, to invest, to partner with you, the chances of you growing your company perhaps nationally, it's there. And I don't often hear these opportunities coming around, so I think it'd be best for you to take this seriously, as we are and as we have, so that you can have that growth prospect going forward.
Mm-hmm. Can you maybe give us your contacts for our listeners who are listening at home? They would love maybe to get more info. Mm-hmm. How do they get hold of you? And can you just repeat, how does one apply through the program?
No problem. So we have made it easy on Facebook and on LinkedIn. There are links. If, for example, and a person is interested and he or she wants to apply or find out more information, there's an email that's attached there.
Okay.
You direct all your concerns or your questions through, and we have a team standing by that will respond. And if they cannot respond, then they direct the questions through to myself or the steering committee, who will respond as soon as we can. There's obviously a lot of applications coming through, so I prompt you all to take this opportunity and just go for it.
Mm-hmm. My last question,
yes,
would be, you know, now that you are talking about a business opportunity,
yes,
there's somebody who has been there, they have a knowledge, mm-hmm, of some of the streams that we spoke about,
yes,
but maybe it's been years, they've never touched anything, they've never fixed anything, but now since you are coming up with opportunities, they would love to be part of it. Are you allowing them to come, or do you need somebody with experience, or are you allowing somebody to start from scratch in the program?
Okay, so I would say to a degree both. We're looking for those, first of all, it's aimed at black business owners.
Okay.
Secondly, preferably women and youth.
Mm-hmm.
Thirdly, for those that has got the urge or hunger to, expand on what they've done previously, as you put it.
Yes.
Why not? It's all about creating a sustainable future for one or the other. So, yes, all they need to do is just come through, apply, submit their details and their documentation that as portrayed in the application phase, and then we will do the vetting in January.
Okay. Mr. Ryan Haynes, thank you very much for your time. We really appreciate you. You just came up with a program that I believe it will help the community in Soshanguve and surroundings. And looking at the issue of unemployment, it is a serious problem. Our sisters and brothers are not working. And, you know, sometimes we complain about crime. It's not because some people want to commit crime, but because of the situation. Sometimes you can judge from the distance. But if you were to hear someone's side, then you will clearly understand what made a person to come out or come up with a certain decision, which as an individual, if you are far away from the situation, you wouldn't understand. So now I believe that next time when we have you here, we will be sitting with our business people who enrolled in the program, and now they will be just giving us the testimonies, and then that will allow others. Now you know how black people we do things, ne? Whenever you see somebody who has done it, that's where you believe it's happening.
Okay.
So I'll be the first one to enroll so that there can be a testimony to others so that they can come. But I believe with this program in Soshanguve, unemployment will decrease.
I hope so. That's the aim of it. That's the aim of it.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mr. Ryan Haynes.
Thanks for giving us the opportunity. And keep well.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Oh, yeah. This isn't goodbye. Even as I watch you leave, this isn't goodbye. I swear I won't cry, even as tears fill my eyes. I swear I won't cry. Any other girl I'd let